Welcome back to Yazzie Family Vlogs and Cooking. Today we're going to be cooking tacos. Well, not me, but...
deep fried tacos.
See, is going to be making deep fried tacos. And we love these tacos. It's made with...
lots of love.
Corn tortillas, ground beef, her secret sauce, secret seasoning. We're going to have rice with it. That's a video that we already done, Mexican rice. We're gonna be having refried beans with it, but we're cheating, we're using a can.
It's still good.
And I also made green chili salsa, so that's gonna go with the tacos. Maybe I'll do a video on that pretty soon. But other than that, let me introduce you to the cook.
Hey guys. Sorry, my hair is a mess. My makeup's not done. I've been cleaning for the past 3 days. But I'm going to show you guys how I make my deep fried tacos that Warren just loves so much. Mm-hmm. So we're going to use corn tortillas. Then we're gonna stuff them with ground beef and deep fry them. But first we're gonna start with the corn tortillas. I have a wet paper towel right here. I'm gonna put about maybe 6 corn tortillas in it, and then I'm gonna put it in the microwave just to soften them up. That way it'll be easy to put the meat on. Okay, we have 8 there. So we're just gonna do this and put it in the microwave for 2 minutes. Okay guys, we have all the tortillas. I warmed them up in the microwave. So now I'm gonna mix all these seasonings with the meat. There's a tablespoon of paprika. I don't think this is gonna be a tablespoon. 1/2 tablespoon of onion salt. One teaspoon of cumin. And then a tablespoon of garlic salt. Then about a teaspoon of pepper.
Oh no, we're out.
A little bit more in there. So I have on my gloves because I don't like how the meat feels when you, or after you mix it up. And I prefer mixing it with my hand, but with gloves on. That way all the grease doesn't get on my hand.
And we're just using ground beef.
Yeah.
You can use you can mix it up if you want. You can do ground beef and add a pork in there. But we all like the beef tacos.
Yep.
You can do turkey if you want, turkey meat.
You're just gonna take your tortilla. Get some of the meat. Put it on the inside and just close it up. So you can do a lot, you can do a little bit for your toppings, but the only thing that we use in this is cheese. We just put cheese on it. We don't use tomato, lettuce, all that. We just put cheese on it when it's done cooking.
Kind of reminds us of the Jack in the Box taco.
Yeah. My favorite. Warren hates it.
I don't like Jack in the Box.
He ordered a burger one time and he was disappointed.
You know, we're coming back from Phoenix and we were hungry. We were starving. We stopped in Payson.
Yeah.
Stopped in Payson and Jack in the Box was on the menu for these guys. It was the Bay and Sue that really wanted it because of the tacos and
the curly fries.
Curly fries. So like I said, we're all hungry and I ordered their Monster Burger that they had advertised on their big old window. I think it's called Monster Burger, right?
Yeah.
Monster Burger or Mega Burger, something like that. So I ordered that. And then these guys got their tacos, they got their chicken bites or whatever it was called. I think chicken tenders. And by the time I got into my burger, that burger was like a McDouble.
Like a kid's meal burger.
I'm like, what the heck? I was all disappointed sitting on the passenger side.
Well, I was enjoying my taco.
And then I think we stopped at the gas station and ended up getting something else over there, right?
Yep.
So after that, I was like, I'm never eating the Jack in the Box. So when we do go there, they just get their tacos. I don't even bother.
So yeah, you just continue doing this until all your tortillas and meat are used up. Then we'll show you the next step.
Got all those tacos.
2 dozen tacos here coming up.
That's why my stomach's big.
Okay, I put about maybe a cup and a half of oil.
Yeah,
about a cup and a half of oil into my favorite pan. Then I just have it on medium, so we're gonna let it heat up. And while this is heating up, I'm gonna get to my rice real quick.
As you guys can see, we use this pan a lot. Can't wait to eat. Then I'm going to be cooking refried beans on the other side, but
my favorite. I'm
not going to be showing that one. The main event is the tacos. Just making rice on this side. She's going to be using tomatoes.
It's supposed to be Roma tomatoes. I like that one better, but
white onion. Yeah, there was no Romas over at Safeway, so we went and picked that one off. Why the vines are still in there?
And for my rice. I love using this one.
Jasmine.
My favorite.
No minute rice, because that cooks different in the Instant Pot, right? That time?
Yeah. 2 cups of rice.
Put some oil in there and she's He's gonna brown it in the Instapot. I guess for this bun, it's a saute, so. Ooh, there's a steam bun. Make a tamale in there.
You can make tamales in there.
You can make tamales? Mm-hmm. Sorry, guys, I'm new to this Instapot myself.
Quicker, faster. If you want fast tamales, maybe I'll use that on. When am I making tamales? Saturday?
Yeah, we're making tamales Saturday. Tamales and menudo.
Yeah, I'm probably going to use that one to try it out. Test it out.
Yeah, we're going to have Mexican. We're going to have tamales, menudo. Might have enchiladas. I'm not too sure. Probably not because we got a lot of menudo. Usually lasts us for like, what, a couple days? Mm-hmm. Maybe we'll have it. I don't know.
I was thinking about that.
Maybe we'll have it because the tamales are going to go really quick.
Yep, they are. First one to go. It takes forever to make it, but 2 seconds to eat.
Yeah, I think I'll make the red end enchiladas. Just good enough for onion. Can you guys see it's kind of turning brown?
Oh, yeah. I was supposed to do a shout out to my sister. She wanted a shout out on this video. Because I was talking to her earlier. And she said, what are you going to make? I said, tacos. She goes, well, do a shout out. Isla Bonnie, this is for you.
Isla Bonnie and Raymond Bonnie and
Dakota. And Autumn.
And Autumn. Meow Meow, which is my other favorite niece.
She volunteered her uncle to babysit her, I guess.
So
she wants her Uncle Warren to babysit.
Yeah, she loves cats. So Binks runs for his life. All you hear is meow meow. Where's meow meow? So.
I took our tree down today too.
Yeah, she took the tree down.
Sad.
I can't lay under the tree now. So yeah, shout out to the Bonnies from
Paradot,
Arizona. Isla and Raymond Bonnie and their kids and their dog and their cats.
Make sure you guys catch up on our channel. We have a lot of videos.
And also we found another channel. She's been on a few lives, and Sue looked her up her channel today.
Yeah. It happened
off the res is the channel. She was telling me about it when I was at work, and I got home, and when I got to sit down, I finally got to watch, I think like 4 or 5 of her videos from the beginning, and it's a pretty good channel.
Yeah, it's a good channel.
Go
check it out.
Yeah, we got more videos to watch on there, so we're probably going to binge watch it this weekend or try to catch a video before we go to bed. So, go check out her channel. It's called It Happened Off the Riz.
Yeah.
So, that's her juice.
My rice. Oil heated up yet?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on, let me do the rice.
So she's got garlic, she's got tomato, she's got onion, she's got the tomato bouillon.
Chicken bouillon. Both of them in there? Yeah. There. And then... tomato. Onion. Now I'm gonna add 3 cups of water. Okay, my rice is brown enough, so I'm just gonna pour this whole mixture in.
Okay, a lot of people have been asking about this Instapot. Do you remember when we had the older version?
Yeah.
The one that you use on the stove and you gotta twist and
those ones are scary. We had it, but I never used it.
How would you...
Because that one has to be at a certain temperature, like when you have the lid on and it has that
releasing. We read some comments from some of you subscribers and you know there are a lot of scary ones, you know, a lot of scary incidents, and you guys been asking about Sue's Instapot, and you know it, you wouldn't say it's 0 to 10, how scary is it?
The stovetop?
That one.
This one's not, because this one, all you do is put the lid on, make sure it's at ceiling's in the middle, and then you press the button and you just let it do its thing. But before you take the lid off, you're gonna have to release the pressure. That's when you put it to venting. All that pressure comes out. Then when the pressure stops, when all that steam's done coming out, that's when you're safe to open.
So you would...
So, I prefer this over the stovetop one because this one is more simpler. Like, we did have the stovetop one a while back. Our old neighbors gave it. No, someone gave it to us.
One of my buddies, he was having a garage sale, and he gave us some dishes.
Yeah, he gave it to him and he brought it home, but I never used it because I was afraid to even touch it. Maybe because it was just the stovetop version.
Yeah, it was just heavy and it was like loose, it rattles everything, huh?
Yeah. So this one, I'm making my rice. I just put the lid on, make sure it's at ceiling. And then like I said, I don't use any of these buttons. The only one I really use is saute when I'm making the rice. So I'm just gonna push manual twice. Then I'm gonna bring it down to 8.
So 8 minutes to cook jasmine rice.
And then after the timer goes off, I let it sit for probably maybe 5 minutes after. So that's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 minutes. And then I switch this to venting, then all that steam and pressure comes out. Putting it in, the rice is done.
So you would say it's really simple, easy to use, you can't burn yourself. Unless you just put your hand in the way of the steam, that's it, right?
Yeah. So this is, for me, it's much more safer than the stovetop version because this is just all digital. You just gotta make sure this is on the ceiling. It took me a while to learn how to use this because this was my mom's. She bought it, of course, just because it's a pioneer woman. She purchased it and it sat there looking pretty. So I told her one day, I said, I should use this, make something in it. She said, yeah, I'll use it. So the first thing I made in it, I think it was pork chops and rice. I fried the pork chops right in it. Took them out, put the rice. No, I had the pork chops on the bottom and the rice on top. And I cooked one whole meal in this. Then ever since then, I kept using it when me and Amaya were out there, and I think I made beans in it once. And then we end up coming back out here to Gallup, and we went back to see her, and she goes, here, you can take this. You know how to use it. I don't know anything about it. You're the only one that used it, so here, take it. So she gave it to me, and
I said we use it like once or twice every 2 weeks. So
yeah.
But it makes the, I mean, we've been trying to do Mexican rice for the longest time. Mexican rice, we tried everything, every...
So, I don't know how many recipes I tried on the Mexican Spanish rice. And I could never get it right. I tried the stovetop.
It's too tomatoey. It's too pasty.
Yeah.
It's too salty.
Then I found a recipe for the Instant Pot. I tried it. I think the first time it didn't come out right.
It kind of had more of a sodium taste to it, huh?
Yeah, it had a lot of, like, a salty taste. And then, second time, I think it was the same. So the third time I got it right. So now I have that recipe in my head.
And I'm telling you guys, that's the best rice I have ever had. And then number two comes that Phoenix place, wherever we eat. I don't even know the name of it.
Casa Reynoso.
Theirs is the second rice I love. And I think the third one have to be Gennaro's. When I stole some of your rice.
Yeah.
Gennaro's here in Gallup. But that rice is good. If some of you guys have tried that recipe, and we have a video on that in our beginning earlier days, and that is good. That's probably the first thing I'll eat tonight. Just kill it with some duck sauce.
But yeah, there's a recipe up on our channel for the rice if you guys want to try it out.
Hey, we got more videos coming up with Instapot, so you guys are gonna have Instapot recipes.
And our
air fryer.
We're gonna do recipes for that. And I don't know how I should say it.
She's to make moonshine.
Would it be a New Year's resolution? You think?
To me?
Yeah. Oh.
I thought you were talking to that person in there.
Poor keto.
I can't last on keto. Keto is good, but I need bread. I'm sorry, people. I need bread.
Yeah, starting next week, I plan to go on the keto diet. Low carb.
High fat.
High fat diet. So next week, you're going to start seeing
keto recipes also.
Keto recipes.
I'm still going to make some of my stuff. But off camera, I'm going to be eating fried bread behind it.
So, yeah. I'm going to try it and see how long I can go.
There's some good recipes that we actually did when we were on keto. Mm-hmm. The best one I think I ever had was her chicken soup. And then there's also the cabbage and sausage that we ate.
Yeah, like the whole week. My favorite.
Then Josiah likes the hamburger casserole. And then, remember when we had the Lucky's rabbit foot one time?
Okay, well, let's get back on track.
Let me get back on the stage.
Oil.
Don't be doing what I did. I was standing like right here, right next to this oil. My back was burning.
Okay, we have the oil. Melting over here. So you just put your tacos in. Just deep fry them. So I just cooked it on one side for 1 minute because the oil was already smoking. So I'm going to do the other side for another minute and then we'll take it out and
I'm going to get some of this.
Yeah. Spicy. They're usually not this brown, but
the oil is really hot.
The oil is really hot. We were just talking away about everything. Okay, so you guys rice recipe again.
Probably gonna cool down pretty soon though.
So that's all it is just deep fried tacos. It's not greasy, so the tacos are not greasy. Then you just take the cheese. What's that noise? The rice is cooking.
See, the rice is cooking. That's just the steam. You can smell it already.
Oh, it's so good.
The tomatoes, the onions. So that's all it is. You just leave it alone. You don't even bother until it starts speaking. Okay, my beans are done. It looks dry on camera, but it's not dry. All I did was put in some oil, put the canned beans in there, and put no seasoning, and then just refried it that way. I'm not a mashed beans type of person, so.
You only like whole beans.
I only like whole beans, not beans like this, but I'm going to eat it though. And that's the last batch of her taco. This one here is off. So she's letting it sit for a couple more minutes and then she's going to release the steam and we'll show you that one too. So we're almost done.
It has to go slow.
You guys should have seen me. I didn't record it. She told me to release the pressure and I just like, this way or this way? She said this way. So I pushed it that way and I got scared. Here I'm all saying it's all simple to use. But yeah, that's all it is. The steam's coming out, so just don't touch it. Leave it alone.
You're supposed to make cookies.
Okay, food's done. We got our rice, we got our beans, we got our tacos done. So, first one to jump to this before I even did is Nevaeh.
Yay.
So I guess she's been waiting for this too, even though I requested these tacos. So let's see, let's get her opinion.
The best tacos ever made. I could have this like a million times.
You like it?
Yeah.
That looks good.
Yes, it is. Now, like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.
Alright, we'll see you guys. Thank you for watching. Peace.
Bye.